What's going on, everyone? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Sunday, July 20th, 2025, 8:45 here in the morning in the great state of New York. Got a couple service calls today. Just got to clean up the schedule. We are just so overwhelmed with service calls and installs during the week that I got to take advantage of a Sunday morning. Heading on my next service call, this is an existing residential client in Rockville Centre. They have a backflow device, a cross containment device that lets water travel in only one direction. Well, these devices need to be tested on an annual basis. They got one of those, we're gonna go test it. I'm gonna show you step by step with my Meta glasses by Ray-Ban. It's awesome, dual cameras, records great picture, great video, and audio. I'll show you step by step how I use the Watts TK9A backflow prevention device tool to test this backflow device. Let's go. I have two Watts 007 M1 QTs, both 1-inch backflow prevention devices. The one for the sprinkler. This is my direction of flow from left to right. Also indicative of that arrow right there. This serial number is 34999 for irrigation. There are two approved test methods for testing a double check valve. I'm going to use one of them, which requires only using one of the hoses connected to one of the test ports. First thing I'm going to do after determining direction of flow is closing shutoff valve number two. And that stops water upflow of the valve. Sorry, what I should have said was to stop flow downstream of the shutoff valve number two. Next, we're going to blow off test ports two, three, and four to remove any debris that may be in the test ports. Take my high pressure hose and connect it to test port number three. I'm going to open up test port number three. And I'm going to bleed air through the backflow testing device by opening up A and B to bleed air through the high pressure hose to my red hose. Next, I'm going to close B. Make note of my pressure, which is right around 73 psi. My needle needs to stay pegged on the high side of the test device. Close shut off valve number one. Make sure she's fully closed. Good. Now we're going to open up valve B and drop our needle to 2 psid. Try that again. I've had some air still in there. Let's, even though I got out a better bucket of water. Okay, pegged on high side. Close one, open B. Two PSID, perfect. Next, we're gonna open test port number two, and the needle should not drop below 1 PSID. And it stayed at 2. So check valve number one has passed. Let's close test port 2 and 3. Restore water by opening service valve number, shutoff valve number one. And we're gonna take our high pressure hose and bring that to test port number four and repeat that process. Open test port 4 valve, purge air through A and B, let's do that one more time, perfect, let's close shutoff valve number 1, lower to 2 PSID. If this rises, by the way, Shutoff valve number one is faulty and device fails. Now we're going to open up test port number three. Just barely dropped, but well above one PSID. This device has passed annual testing. Okay, one of the things we're also going to make sure that there's no connections before the containment device, such as a hose faucet or a T going somewhere else. Also, it's a good time to make a visual observation. Look at the oxidization or the cement interacting with the copper. There. And this is our irrigation line. There as well. They never sleeved it. Crazy. So let's say if this, for example, was before here, no bueno. So this is good. Both devices passed. This is also a great time to make sure you have valve tags on the main water valve. And also it's great for branding. Marked main water. I don't need to put one here as well. This is the sprinkler. This is my main for the house. We're good.